When you read the question, they have given one quadratic equation, x square plus 3x plus 7. And also they mentioned alpha and beta are what? Roots of the equation. Whenever a quadratic equation is given, it is not necessary to find the roots. Directly you can use sum of roots formula. Again, in this problem, we use the identity. What is the identity we use? A cube plus b cube. In any problem, first your task is to get sum of roots and product of roots. In any problems based on alpha, beta, first task is find sum of the roots, then you find product of roots. Welcome to the session, dear students. Today we'll go ahead with the problems of theory of equations, exercise 6.2. See, in exercise 6.2, solve the following. If alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation, x square plus 3x plus 7 equal to 0, find the values of alpha cube plus beta cube. So when you read the question, they have given one quadratic equation, x square plus 3x plus 7. And also they mentioned alpha and beta are what? Roots of the equation. They want you to find the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. See, now first consider the quadratic equation. So you know quadratic equation is in the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 represents what? Quadratic equation. What is the equation they gave? They gave x square plus 3x plus 7 equal to 0 is the equation they gave. So now by comparison, in the place of a we have 1, in the place of b we have 3, in the place of c we have 7. So a is 1, b is 3, c is 7. So now go to a value, we know. What is a value? 1. B value 3, c value 7. Now find sum of the roots. Alpha plus beta stands for sum of the roots, that is minus b by a, that is minus 3 divided by 1, that will be alpha plus beta. Minus 3 by 1 is minus 3, so you got alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is exactly minus 3. So now we got alpha plus beta. Now we go to product of roots. Product of roots means what? Alpha into beta, that is c by a. What is c in this problem? 7. By a is what? 1. So 7 by 1 is 7. So alpha into beta you got. Alpha beta is what? 7. So now we got sum of roots, that is minus 3, product of roots 7. They want you to find alpha cube plus beta cube. They want you to find what? Alpha cube plus beta cube. So all of you know we have an identity. So we can use this, that is all of you know a cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b the whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. A cube plus b cube we can also write in the form a plus b the whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. See, coming to the point here, alpha into beta is 7, alpha plus beta is minus 3. Now they want you to find alpha cube plus beta cube. You know that alpha cube plus beta cube can be written as alpha plus beta the whole cube minus 3 times alpha into beta into alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is minus 3. So minus 3 the whole cube minus 3 times alpha into beta. What is alpha into beta? Here we got 7. So alpha into beta is 7 into what? Alpha plus beta is minus 3. So minus 3 cube is minus 27. 3 3s are 9, 3s are 27. Minus cube becomes minus. Minus into minus plus. 3 3s are 9, 9 7s are 63. So now simplify this. 63 minus 27. 63 minus 20 gives you 43. 43 minus 7 gives you 40. 63. 20 if you remove it will become 43. 43 minus 7 gives you 36. So you got the value. Therefore alpha cube plus beta cube they wanted, and you got the value of alpha cube plus beta cube exactly how much? 36. So in these kind of problems, first you should know the formula for sum of the roots and product of the roots. Whenever a quadratic equation is given, it is not necessary to find the roots. Directly you can use sum of roots formula. What is sum of roots? Alpha plus beta gives you what? Minus b by a. And what is product of roots? Alpha into beta, that gives you what? C by A. Use that and get the value. But here very important thing is you need to know the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. So for that you should know A cube plus B cube. What is a cube plus b cube? A cube plus b cube in maths can be written as a plus b the whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. Now we'll go to the next problem. If alpha and beta are the roots of the equation x cube plus 3x plus 7 equal to 0, find the values of alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. Again, usual. So by method of comparison, they give x square plus 3x plus 7 equal to 0. So now this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now by method of comparison, in the place of a we have 1, in the place of b we have 3, in the place of c we have 7. So we got the value of a, b, c. So a is what? 1, b is quotient of x, that is 3, and constant is 7. A is 1, b is 3, c is 7. Now sum of the roots, alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a. That is minus 3 divided by 1. That is minus 3. Sum of the roots is same, minus 3. Then similarly, find product of roots. What is product of roots? Alpha into beta, that is c by a. And what is c value here? 7 divided by a is what? 1. 7 by 1 is 7. So alpha into beta is 7. And now after you get the value of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, go for what they want. They want alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. They want you to calculate alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. Simplify this. First take LCM. What is the LCM? Beta into alpha. Cross multiply. Alpha square into alpha is alpha cube plus beta square into beta is beta cube. And you know a cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b the whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. So alpha cube plus beta cube can be written as alpha plus beta the whole cube minus 3 alpha beta into alpha plus beta. This is the identity we used in the last case also. Now beta into alpha or alpha into beta I can write, because a into b is same as b into a. Now substitute the values. You know the value of what? Alpha plus beta. What is value of alpha plus beta? Minus 3. In the place of alpha plus beta, put minus 3. Whole cube minus 3 times alpha into beta. What is alpha into beta? We got 7. So in the place of alpha into beta, substitute 7. Into alpha plus beta is what? Minus 3. Divided by alpha into beta is again 7. Further simplify this. That is minus 3 the whole cube minus minus into minus plus I can write. So 3 into 7 into 3 divided by 7. This is what we had. Simplify, this will become minus 27 plus 63 divided by 7. 63 minus 27 becomes 36 by 7. So earlier we calculated alpha cube plus beta cube already. So if you refer the last problem, in last problem we got 36, same numerator here. What is the same numerator? Numerator is again 36. So they want you to find the value of what? They want you to find alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. And what is the value you got? 36 by 7. Again, in this problem, we use the identity. What is the identity we used? A cube plus B cube. What is A cube plus B cube? A plus B the whole cube minus 3AB into A plus B. Here, instead of alpha cube plus beta cube, here we have alpha cube plus beta cube. We use alpha plus beta the whole cube minus 3 times alpha into beta into alpha plus beta. Further, alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation 2x square plus 5x plus 5 equal to 0. Find the value of 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. So as usual, first compare the quadratic equation. They give 2x square plus 5x plus 5 equal to 0, and compare it with standard quadratic equation, that is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. By method of comparison, a you will get 2, b you will get 5, and c you will get 5. ABC value got. So now go to sum of roots, alpha plus beta. You know what is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a, that is minus 5 by 2. This is alpha plus beta. You got alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is minus 5 by 2. Then similarly, find alpha into beta. What is alpha into beta? Product of roots, that is C by A. What is C? 5. What is A? 2. So alpha into beta is exactly 5 by 2. So in any problem, first your task is to get sum of roots and product of roots. Here there is no necessity to solve and get the roots. You no need to factorize, you no need to use formula to get the roots. Just use the sum of roots and product of roots formula. What is sum of roots? Minus b by a, I'll get minus 5 by 2. What is product of roots? C by a, I'll get 5 by 2. So we'll use sum of roots and product of roots and we'll go ahead. So here they want you to find 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. What is sum of roots? Alpha plus beta, we got minus 5 by 2. We'll take the help of this to arrive at the result what they want. Alpha into beta, what is alpha into beta? They give 5 by 2. So now using these two, they want 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta, that is, if you take LCM, it will become alpha into beta, cross multiply, it will become beta plus alpha. That is, numerator can be written as alpha plus beta, denominator can be written as alpha into beta. Numerator is sum of roots, denominator is product of roots. What is sum of roots? Minus 5 by 2. Divided by what is product of roots? 5 by 2. So, dear students, we can write it as minus 5 by 2 into reciprocal 2 by 5. So 5 cancels, 2 cancels, we will get minus 1. So therefore we got 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta value. What is 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta? That is exactly minus 1. So in this problem, they asked you to find 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. Take LCM, alpha into beta will be the LCM, cross multiply, it will become beta plus alpha. You know, addition is commutative, means beta plus alpha is same as alpha plus beta. So I'll rewrite it, alpha plus beta. You know the value of alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? Minus 5 by 2. We got the value of alpha plus beta, minus 5 by 2. In the place of alpha plus beta, put minus 5 by 2. And we got the value of alpha into beta, that is 5 by 2. In the place of this, 5 by 2 cancels. We'll be left out with what? Minus 1. So this is the value what they want. Then, again, if alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation 2x square plus 5x plus 5, they want you to find 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So by method of comparison, so they give 2x square plus 5x plus 5 equal to what? 0. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is the quadratic equation. By method of comparison, what is a? 2. What is b? 5. What is c? 5 again. So now go for alpha plus beta, sum of the roots. What is sum of roots formula? Minus b by a. So what is minus b by a? Means 5 by 2. So minus 5 by 2. So again we got alpha plus beta, sum of the roots, that is minus 5 by 2. They don't want this value, but we use this as intermediate. In any problems based on alpha beta, first task is find sum of the roots, then you find product of roots. Let them give any problem. First your task is to find sum of roots and product of roots. We'll utilize it to find the required value. Alpha into beta. What is alpha into beta? Product of roots, that is C by A. What is C? 5 by 2. C by A is 5 by 2. So you got alpha into beta, that is 5 by 2. So you know sum of roots, you know product of roots. So once you know sum of roots and product of roots, then you should go ahead with the problem. What is the problem? They want you to calculate 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So they want you to find 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So take LCM. What is LCM? LCM is alpha square plus beta square, cross multiply, it will become beta square plus alpha square, or I can rewrite it as alpha square plus beta square, a square plus b square into alpha beta the whole square. Can I write alpha square plus beta square, alpha square into beta square? Can I write it as alpha beta the whole square? Because we know the value of alpha beta. But numerator, when you observe, numerator is alpha square plus beta square. Now our task is to find alpha square plus beta square. For that, we'll use the identity what you know, that is a square plus b square. So can I write a square plus b square as a plus b the whole square minus 2ab? Simple, you know a plus b the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus 2ab. Transfer 2ab to that side, that's it. So now a square plus b square can also be written as a plus b the whole square minus 2ab. Means now I made it as sum of roots and product of roots. So here similarly alpha square plus beta square, use this logic and write alpha square plus beta square. Now alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta the whole square minus 2 times alpha beta, can I write? Divided by alpha beta the whole square. So now we'll simplify this, that is alpha plus beta the whole square minus 2 times alpha beta divided by alpha beta the whole square. So substituting in this, what is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is minus 5 by 2, minus 5 by 2 the whole square, minus 2 times alpha beta. What is alpha beta? 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 the whole square. So simplify, 2 cancels. So minus the whole square is plus 25 by 2 minus 5 divided by 5, 25 by 4. 5 square is 25, 2 square is 4. Further numerator, after squaring, we will take LCM. So if we take LCM for numerator 2, 25 minus 2 into 5 is 10. Whole thing divided by 25 by 4. Further simplify, 25 minus 10 is 15 by 2 divided by 25 by 4. That is 15 by 2. Into take reciprocal, it will be 4 by 25. 2 1s are 2s are and 5. 3s are 5, 5s are. So 3 2s are 4 by 5. Finally, you are left out with what? 4 by 5. So when you take LCM, 2 5s are 10, it will become 25 minus 10 is 15. 15 by 2 divided by 25 by 4. Take it to numerator. It will become 4 by 25. 2 2s are 4. 3 into 2, that is 6 divided by what is left out? 5. 6 by 5 is the answer. I hope all of you got this. Further, they gave the quadratic equation 2x square plus 5x plus 5 equal to 0. Same quadratic equation. They want alpha by beta plus beta by alpha. So now by method of comparison, so 2x square plus 5x plus 5 equal to 0, compare it with standard equation, that is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, and get the value of a is 2, b is 5 and c is 5, and sum of roots, product of roots. What is alpha plus beta? Say minus b by a, that is minus b is what? Minus 5 divided by 2. What is product of roots? Alpha into beta, that is c by a. What is c here? 5 by 2. So now you got alpha plus beta, that is minus 5 by 2, and product of roots alpha into beta, that is 5 by 2. Now you know sum of roots and product of roots, and what they want you to find? Alpha by beta plus beta by alpha. They want alpha by beta plus beta by alpha. So we can take LCM. What is the LCM? Beta into alpha, cross multiply, it will become alpha square plus beta square. Same method, what we can do? So a plus a square plus b square can be written as a plus b the whole square minus 2ab divided by a square plus b square. Alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta the whole square minus 2 alpha beta divided by alpha into beta. Coming to this, what is alpha plus beta the whole square? So that is minus 5 by 2 the whole square divided by what is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is 5 by 2. So can I write it as minus the whole square is plus? So 5 by 2 into 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2. Square means into 2. Cancel, so you are left out with positive 5 by 2. So you got what? 5 by 2. So now here we use what? A square plus B square. Alpha square plus beta square if you see. So we need A square plus B square. A square plus B square can be written as A plus B the whole square minus 2AB. So dear students, today whatever the problems we have done, all are based on what? Sum of roots and product of roots. Let me summarize. See, what are the basics to solve the problems of the exercise 6.2? First one is, for a quadratic equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, you should know what is alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a. And you should know product of roots, alpha into beta, c by a. And we should know a cube plus b cube. So wherever it is required, we can write a cube plus b cube as a plus b the whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. And also a square plus b square. A square plus b square can also be written as a plus b the whole square minus 2ab into a plus b. Means here a and b, we replace it with what? Alpha and beta. So in many situations, we'll get alpha square plus beta square. And many situations, we'll get alpha cube plus beta cube. So we can use this following identities to solve the problems. So sit and prepare or practice all these problems without fail. So today I've done some problems based on what? Sum of roots and product of roots. Please use this and solve the problems. I'll see you in my next session. Till then, please practice all the problems related with alpha beta. I'll see you in my next session. Thanks for attending. Thank you.